Alrighty guys, hello guys, how are you doing today? Better not be lipstick in my teeth. We're good. Woo! I am doing, I need to like start looking up more words. Because I don't want to say good, I don't want to say okay, I don't want to say like, I am doing confused. I'm confused. That's how I'm doing. Just confused. So clearly, I took a little bit of time off again. Oh, I really, really, really don't try to do that. Like, I actually have so much footage over the past week of what I've been going through and my mindset, but I didn't want to post them because I don't want to be a boohoo channel. So I'm going to put some of those clips in right now of, you know, my past week. So yeah, it's been difficult, but you know, I feel like I just really need to let it out, get back into the gym, and really like refocus. Unfortunately, I kind of let go of meditating, journaling, and yoga. But I picked back up major weightlifting, eating 3 to 4 meals a day, getting enough sleep, and being super organized and clean, and working on my website, but not doing videos. So it's like I'm still winning, but I'm still losing. Like I'm still like not 100% where I need to be, but I'm making progress. I'm like switching on and off of what I'm supposed to be doing. It's really conflicting, it's really confusing, but I'm just trying to do my best every single day and pick myself back up. So if you guys don't already know, I basically made this channel to talk about my mental health, my mental state, and my journey to self-love, and I'm trying to show how I'm gonna get to where my end goal in life is, which is to be a business owner and have my own business stuff. I don't want to talk too much about it because it's like not even near done or like ready for me to talk about, but like this is my journey to getting to the person that I know I'm meant to be. There's a lot of people that make it, but they never really show how they did it. So I'm just trying to document my process and like pick myself back up and really go after my goals in this lifetime. I was also sick for the past week. I'm just now gaining my voice back. Whew. it's been fun. I have been, like, going out and, like, actually doing things, which is amazing. That's another thing I just haven't been documenting, which is kind of frustrating. Me and some of my roommates went to MB2. We went to this really cool hike. We all went bowling and got super drunk. I've just been going to the grocery store nonstop, like, errands nonstop, like, doing, like, actual things rather than sulking in bed. Like, I haven't been sulking, but I just haven't been able to pick up the camera because my mind has been all over the place. And I'm going to open up to you guys a little bit about something. Maybe I shouldn't, but I'm going to anyway. So obviously I am going through a breakup right now. And if you guys don't know, or if you haven't watched this video, I am extremely codependent. And my last relationship was codependent up the wazoo. It was the definition of codependent. So I am going through the codependent withdrawals at this very moment. And if you've never had codependent withdrawals, or you don't suffer from codependency, basically it's trying to break your addiction to something like heroin or crack, or like a legit drug where it just, it's impossible. Like, it's like an alcoholic that he can't just, like, go sober. Even my dad, he was constantly trying to go sober, but he couldn't ever just go sober. He had to wean himself off of it. And the last time we got back together, I basically explained to him that, can we just make this our weaning process? And can we just, you know, lay each other down gently? Because we both knew how strong of a drug we were together. So basically, when I keep saying that we both kind of knew the relationship was going to come to end, we did. We just were addicted to each other. And addiction and love are not the same thing. They feel identical, but they're not. Addiction controls you. Love flourishes you. So don't be addicted to your significant other. It's not healthy. Anyway, but that weaning thing didn't really work between us because, I couldn't help myself. That's like my ultimate drug is that person. So this whole breakup thing right now, it's been a month and a week now. Damn, that is so good. I'm so proud of me. Yeah, it's been brutal because I'm walking away from my addiction and I'm, like, curing myself of a really bad addiction. So it's been difficult. So my mental state, like, has not been there. And a codependent, when they are alone, have a really hard time being alone. And I don't know. I never want to sound cocky, too confident, or any of those things. I'm just trying to be real with you. And on a real note, I really necessarily don't have problem with boys or men. They're not necessarily ones I actually find attractive or want to be with or have a real connection with, but a lot of them will come in my life, whether it's through DMs, through Instagram, or, you know, just going to the grocery store, there'll be guys that ask for my number, or even the gym. Like, it's just a constant, I can constantly have a new fix if I want it. So even though my ex was like my drug, my fix, it doesn't mean that there's not other drugs out there for me that are just waiting for me to taste. So it gets really hard because I'm not tempted to be with another person or want to be with another person, but a codependent has a really hard time being lonely, and I'm more of an emotional bonding person, not a physical bonding person. So I'm always looking for, like, an emotional support system, someone that I can rely on with my emotions, someone I could just sit there and talk to until my voice goes out. Like, I look for emotional companions. So, you know, sometimes there's some people that knock on this door and I'll be very intrigued to open up that emotional door. And it gets me in a crap ton of trouble when I'm in a heartbreak like this. I kind of fell into a trap. I'm not gonna go into too much detail, but I have a past with this one person, and he came knocking on my door. I think we both knocked on each other's door at the same time, just kind of frustrating. But anyway, I just realized, like, wow, you are not emotionally prepared for this. You cannot go down this road. And it was really daunting on my ego, surprisingly. I don't have any idea why, but it really taught me, like, you are not even remotely close to ready to even have any type of man, like, not interaction, just in general. Like, not even when it comes to anything besides just literally I can't even talk to other men right now. So it was a big realization for me. I'm very grateful for it, but it was messing with my head so badly. Because since I did have a past with this person, I already know that they're a different type of drug for me. And I like that drug too, I'm not gonna lie. So it's just like, damn, stop it, Marissa. Like, we're trying to, you know, be in love with ourselves and be our own drug and be addicted to myself. Like, the whole point of this self-love journey now is to give all the love I used to give away to myself for once. Like, that's part of the self-love journey, is truly giving yourself all you for once in your life. Like, just one time in your life, do that for yourself so you know what it feels like. And I need to teach myself what that feels like, because you don't know what happens in the future. Like, neither of us know what goes on in our future. But I know in my childhood, I saw some shit go down that I can never unsee. Like, I saw families in my life, like, have their whole life ripped apart from them, and they had to start all over. Like, life happens, and I don't want to be clueless to that. Like, even though I'm a very spiritual, positive person, I'm very fucking realistic. I'm very, like, looking 1,000 steps ahead, sometimes too much. So I just know that I have to do this for once in my lifetime so that my future, I will know how to pick myself back up if something does go down ever. Because I know my mental state, and I know I had a mental breakdown at 22 years old over some stuff that, like, yeah, is hard, but it's really not that hard. So imagine if some real stuff happened to me. Ooh! And if I had kids, oh, I can't. I have to get this in wraps. I have to control this and love thyself. So yeah, I was dealing with a little bit of, like, the ness. And I just didn't want you guys to really see that side of me, because it's really ugly. It's really insecure. It's just really not my genuine self. It's a very, oof, yeah, not me. It's very self-doubting. It's very either self-doubting or self-loathing. I just don't understand why I do that. I walk myself down traps and then get mad that I'm in a trap. And I'm like, you literally knew this was a trap and you still walked into it, yet you're still mad at us. Okay. And that's me sounding like a crazy person talking in third person. But I believe people have, like, the good side and the bad side constantly on their shoulder. Like, your higher self and your intuition, and then your self-doubt, childhood, subconscious mind behaviors. Like, I feel like they're both right here, and you have to just keep tuning in to the higher self one and be like, no, 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 rather than being like, ah! Yeah, so. Anywho, so I'm back on my journaling shiz. And by the way, guys, I've been journaling every day for quite some time, except for this past week, so I was a little disappointed on myself. But this is my journal. It's already almost done, and I've only had it for not that long at all. So I've been journaling my life away, and honestly, journaling for your mental health / self-love journey is a necessity. I just wanted to throw this in there, because if you don't journal, okay, so why journaling is so important to me is because it kind of shows you you're crazy. Like, there's one thing thinking all these thoughts, but there's another thing when you actually are physically writing it, where you're able to be like, wow, I really think this way. I really believe these things. And then there's a way of, like, I believe writing is magical. Like, I believe writing and words in general is magic. Like, there's no other way to describe how beautiful language is to me than through writing. I'm obsessed with it. I low-key am a little poet at heart. I love good poetry and some good ass books. You guys know I'm a reader. Like, come on. I love words. Anyway, I've been really paying attention to journaling, and I just kind of learned about scripting. So this is like a little homework thing you guys can do for yourself right now. So I learned about scripting and basically like it's standards that you used to get in school where you just have to write the same thing over and over again, but it helps you either get rid of something or attract something into your life. So for me, I surrender fear, and as you can tell, I just went on all day long. And then there's like other statements you can do where it's, you can say, I'm so grateful and abundant. Thank you, universe, for this beautiful life. And I'll do that over and over again. But when I'm having like a really anxious time, I'll just script and I'll just write and write and write. And that's basically why this notebook is so full already. But scripting really has been helping me. So I'm back on that grind. This video, I just really wanted to catch you guys up on what the heck happened. Just know, again, I'm going through a really hard transition, a transition I forgot was this hard. Even though it's not as hard as all the other times, it is still so gruesome. Maybe I shouldn't have shared everything I shared in this video, but you know what? I'm trying to, you know, vlog this life of mine. I gotta be honest. but yeah, just know I'm still here. I'm still on YouTube every single day. I'm still looking up things. I still have my little playlist and I upload new videos that I'm currently watching on those playlists. I'm still very active on my Instagram story. I'm still active. It's just very hard to be this active when you're going through a really hard time of your life. You just don't want people to really like see that side of you. I already showed you guys anyway. Like, you guys know I'm not afraid to cry. Show you guys my weird thoughts and show you guys the weird side of me, but you know, so be it. Whatever I'm doing this for, I'm doing it for whatever reason. I don't even know sometimes. But anyway, I got a lot of stuff to do. I've been slacking so bad for the past 2 days. I've just been like in such a weird funk. It's because I had to go see my ex. And it's just, you ever gone through a breakup? That's the worst part, is seeing them again, or it's just, it messes you up so bad. Like, I can't do cold turkey because I've done cold turkey before and that shit backfires so much harder than like doing it this way, but it's still really hard call. So yeah, I was having a really hard time the past 2 days, but doesn't mean it's ruining the rest of this week for me. I'm going to the gym later on with my mom. I have to do something for a friend, and I'm about to clean the house and then hopefully edit this video by tonight and have it up by tomorrow. And hopefully I'm back on schedule, because your girl has been getting up every single day at 4:30 and going to the gym with Carla. And I felt amazing. I've been eating this big old breakfast, having a nice lunch, having a nice dinner. I'm doing it. I just need to bring it all together. Okay, that's what's going on, guys. I'm gonna bring it in all together. Okay, guys. I don't know if that video was annoying or if I'm just like really hyper because I had a lot of coffee. I don't know what. But I will see you guys very shortly. And thank you guys for being honestly so patient with me. I know you guys deserve more, and I'm gonna try my best to deliver that. Even though I've been silent when it came to posting, I've been trying to learn better ways to edit, learning more graphic arts I can bring into my videos, trying to do better sound, trying to do better lighting. I'm just trying to progress and evolve, and that takes some time, as you guys probably know through experience with your own life. Just, you know, things take a lot of time. Gotta have some patience. And don't forget, you are what you mother effing think about. All the time. You are what you think about. Be careful of that. Catch yourself. Be self-aware. Have some self-love for yourself and nip yourself in the butt. Be the parent you've always needed. Stop self-doubting yourself. Amen. Do you hear that, Marissa? I'm talking to myself too, guys. Talking to myself. Okay, seriously. Bye.